Hello guys, and welcome to another NCLEX question review. Today's question should be easy enough if you know your lab values for blood components. For the purpose of this video, we'll pretend that you are unsure of the correct lab values, and we'll do a quick review of the key concepts we'll find in this question. Our question reads, a nurse is caring for a client with a diagnosis of gout. Which of the following laboratory values would the nurse expect to note in the client? Option A, calcium levels of 9.0 milligrams per deciliter. Option B, uric acid level of 8.6 milligrams per deciliter. Option C, potassium level of 4.1 milliequivalent per liter. Option D, phosphorus level of 3.1 milligrams per deciliter. Before you pick an answer, let's review the pathophysiology for gout. And make sure that you check at the very end of this video for a table of correct lab values in case you need to review them. Now, our question remains, what is gout? Gout is a form of inflammatory arthritis characterized by recurrent attacks of a red, tender, hot, and swollen joint. An attack of gout can occur suddenly, often waking up the client in the middle of the night with the sensation that the big toe is on fire. Pain typically comes on rapidly, in less than 12 hours after the initial symptoms. The affected joint is so hot, swollen, and tender that even the weight of the sheet on it may seem intolerable. This is commonly referred to as a gout attack. The joint at the base of the big toe is affected in about 50% of the cases. When the metatarsal phalangeal joint is affected, it is called podagra. There are two major types of gout, primary gout and secondary gout. Primary gout is classified as an inborn error of purine metabolism due to genetic factors. In primary gout, production of uric acid exceeds the body's excretion capability. Secondary gout involves hyperuricemia caused by another disease or factor, such as renal insufficiency, multiple myeloma, and cardiovascular disease. How is uric acid formed, and where does it come from? DNA is found in cells of all living organisms, including the food we eat and our own cells. DNA is broken down into simpler molecules called purines. An end product of purine metabolism is uric acid. Gout is due to elevated levels of uric acid in the blood. Normally, your kidneys take uric acid out of your blood and put it into urine so that it can leave your body. But sometimes, your body either produces too much uric acid or your kidneys excrete too little. This occurs due to a combination of diet and genetic factors. At high levels, uric acid crystallizes. When this happens, uric acid can build up, forming sharp, needle-like uric crystals in a joint or surrounding tissue that can cause pain, inflammation, and swelling. Back in the Middle Ages, it used to be known as the disease of kings, since it was mainly seen in wealthy men who drank and ate too much, especially beer. Now we know it can occur in anyone, and can be associated with injury or surgical procedures, hospitalizations, periods of stress, or reactions to diet high in meat and seafood, as well as certain drugs and antibiotics. As a strategy to answer this question, use the process of elimination and knowledge of normal laboratory values. Recalling that increased uric acid levels occurred in gout, and noting that option B is the only abnormal value will assist you in answering this question. Now that we've seen the symptoms associated with gout, you should be able to identify the right answer. In this case, the expected lab values for uric acid in a client with a diagnosis of gout are going to be elevated, making option B your only possible answer. Note that these values are elevated, since normal uric acid levels ranges from 2.5 to 8 milligrams per deciliter. Make sure you subscribe to our channel. We have tons of more questions and videos coming up. Hit the like button if you found this video to be helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. Thanks again for watching and see you on the next video.